Hi guys, we're not giving up on this pandemic. We're sick of it, but we're not giving up. We keep fighting it. And I'm keeping raking my brain and coming up with new style of mask. This time I call it no fog mask, because that's how people call it on internet. But I really tell you what, every mask will be a no fog mask as long as you slide that mask a little bit under your glasses. It immediately become no fog, no wall. But I'm gonna put in the name of it no fog, because that's what people looking for. And I like this particular pattern what I come up with, because it's only like under 1 minute to make it. I will show to you right now and prove to you how easy to make it. And also whole mask process making taking very short time. And most of what I like about this mask, I still have choices to go over ears or over my head for long haul. Over my head is actually better. And I will explain to you later in the video why and how. And also I'm always on the side of filter. I keep telling you that. And depend what kind of cotton. Obviously, 100% cotton has to be used for making this mask. Can be used lightweight, medium weight, and heavyweight. If you're using heavyweight cotton, it will be very hard to breathe if you put filter inside. I strongly suggest to start to use medium or lightweight cotton where you can slide filter inside. What to use for filter is later on coming up. And also, I really like this pattern because it's easy for me to sew in filter inside. It will be permanent there, washable, and between two layers of mask. Let's begin. This is square what we cut and what we use for it. Notebook. I just put with postal tape together. Notebook right here in the middle of it. Two pages glued together. And what I do? I turn that exactly. How big is this square? How big is this square? 13 inches this way, 9.5 this way. 13, 9.5. Now, put it halfway like that. See, no measurements, just put it like that. You go from left to right, fold it one time. Now, from bottom to top, fold it one more time like that. Forget my writing here. Now, fold it one more time, again, from left to right, this way. Crease it, mark it, this is your half. Crease it one more time. This is going to be your another half. I kind of know where it is visual. I don't even need to crease it. You mark now from this point down, 1.5 inches, 1.5. From this corner out here, 1.5. From this corner up, 2 inches. I have my good measurements. That's why I don't even need to do it now. Connect this cut up with this one like that. This one with this one right here. Now cut it by these lines. You done. You got your pattern. Did I manage it under 1 minute? I believe I did. Here you are. You cut it your fabric. What else we need? We need filter, because filter will be permanently sewn inside this mask. And what we use for filter? Polypropylene. In my case, any polypropylene will be good, and because that's the best filter. First of all, why we need filter? Right above my video, above my talking white line, click on it. It will take you to another video, explain to you how a filter works and why we need it. Just only 3 minutes video. It's easy to watch. And also, where to get it? What is polypropylene and where to get it? Again, right above my talk in another video. Click on it. This will take you to second video, which is tell you where to get it for a very reasonable price. And we use the best one, which is it's a whole yard medical material. It's proved to be antibacterial. It's not proved to be antiviral yet, because it is no investigations, no searches done on that point yet. But that's what hospitals use for cover surgery on tables, for your hospital curtains, a lot for dressing up doctors in surgery rooms. That's what hospitals use. No, well, it's really good filter. And what we're going to do? We're going to sew that here and let's flip it. Let's flip it. And that's going to be our mask point right here. No, well, it's mean we have to place it somewhere right there. This is our bending on the mask, and you're gonna put, you want to put one piece or you want to put on the both sides, depend how much filtration you needed. If you use heavy cotton, you cannot use more than one layer because it will be hard to breathe. But if it's light cotton or medium cotton, like in my case, I can use both sides, but just to make it faster this video, I will use just one layer. And I kind of place in the middle randomly and sew around that perimeter. Okay, now let's flip it again, right side in, and what we're gonna stitch here, we're gonna just check it how it's laying, and we're gonna stitch these pieces together like that on the both sides all together. Now, when you stitch those things together, you become your Olson shape mask. That's what we want. Everything away from your mouth, with nothing bothering you. And put it like that all together, our cuts all together, our darts, what we make right here, all together. And now we can stitch it. Let's start stitching from this point. By time when you get in here, this is your side. This is your side, this wider part, and what you can do, if you want to have your mask around ears, cut from your t-shirt, but your t-shirt, I told you already, has to be not 100% cotton, it has to be 95-98% cotton and the rest spandex, because it has to be more easy to stretch, to make beautiful, nice, strong, and very good tie, which is not going to be worn up like elastic. And what you do, you cut that old shirt half inch wide, if you don't have your own, go on thrift store, buy one, and then stretch it out. Stretch it out, and when you, after you stretch it, that's what you come up with. In stretching form, when it's already in stretching form, it's very comfy, it's very light. Get about 7-inch tie. That's going to be your long, how long in stretchable, stretched form already. And then when before you stitch in this side, what you do, you put this one in like that. And make sure you stitch well, like at least here you can do your quarter inch stitching here, but here make sure it's a half inch going through. Again, quarter, 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 half inch there. Last corner don't stitch, because that's gonna be our turnaround, turn inside. Okay, here you are. I stitch sides half inch away from the end, and this angle cuts, I stitch a quarter inch away, except one last one. I left it open, because that's our hole to turn everything inside out. All right, everything right way, and well, only one corner open, just turn in like quarter inch, just like was another one done, and stitch it this time. And while you're stitching, continue stitching, you can press, of course. Of course you can press, I don't feel like it necessary, but you can press it. After you stitch, when you start stitching this corner, kind of go around and stitch around perimeter whole piece. Crest up, and well, which way to put, this way or that way? You can see your square filter stitch there, leave it inside. It's mean your band will go over, leave inside filter, your band under chin, this is our chin part, will go this way. Now we have to come up with covering for your nose to make sure glasses is not fogging. What we do, let's turn it no more is inch and a quarter. Inch and a quarter fold inside this mask and stitch it. This corner stitch it and that corner stitch it down. You got it. Now, this flap, put flap a little bit up, like 90 degree right here. Here is your one corner, what you just stitch. 90 degree right here. Not really 90, it's a, make sure this corner is 90. Your fold going up to create another 90 degree corner, and stitch right here only quarter inch. Back and forth with machine only quarter inch. Okay, this is the construction what you end up with. Just like that, and this is your nose going right here. This piece is not constantly bothering you, staying down constantly, because we stitch quarter inch up here, quarter inch, it's easy to wear it. And well, only now we have to finish up, we need to put those ties around, going around head, just like I like it. Okay, that's what you will have if you put these ties around ears. This kind of construction in your mask is ready, but that's what I have, because it's not ready yet, not ready yet, just one moment. Well, it's gonna be gap right here on the sides. Now, well, to kill that gap, we kind of need to put it together and run a half inch dart, half inch deeper, and only about just a half inch this way, half inch that way, just a tiny little dart. After you make this dart kind of in the middle somewhere, make sure you stitch it down flat. What, stitch it right here over, what is going to be flat, it's not going to be bothering your chin when. Now, this one is ready. But try it on, laying perfect, no gaps, no way around. And this one, we still need to make ways for our ties. What t-shirt better? Pieces of t-shirt, just cut and put it there. Why better? Because you don't need overlock. Because t-shirt is not gonna run on you. Or filter pieces, anything like that. But t-shirt will be best. Okay, guys, if something come up, don't precise something, you see some difference between two sides, don't worry about it. Worry about finishing your mess, don't worry about little stuff like that. Well, I put these pieces more tight, more close to the chin, as you can see, not to the top here. Here I have about half inch gap on the top, right here where is my nose will be. It is for a reason, because in this case, mask, when ties come up, when my ties come up exactly on the angle a little bit here, it's gonna sit better on my face and on my head, period, that mask. In this case, look, it's again, at least half inch up, at least 3/4 in this case, even up right here between. It's all good. It's all good, don't worry about it. It's still gonna fit very good. Now, guys, let's finish this mask. You need a t-shirt again. Check on the tag. It has to be no more as 95-98% cotton and rest is spandex, because it's make easy to stretch it, make it super comfortable to hook up for your mask. Because, you know, it's so dry us now, this mask. Everybody is so crazy or tired of this mask. Make it as comfortable as possible. Well, cut the stripe from the t-shirt, which is a half inch wide only. And then what you do, you stretch it like that, as far as can gets, as far as can gets. Stretch it as far as can gets, and it's come up with really nice and tiny piece like that, and it's not running. And let me show to you what you do next with that. You take a safety pin, hook up to that string, run through all the things, and it's one string going this way and that way back. One string, it's important. Because it has to be freely movable after we're done with that. Just like that. And how long it's supposed to be right here, after you put mask like that, it's supposed to stick out no more as 4 inches. If it's laying like that, no more as 4 inches. Make sure here you have the same. No more as 4 inches, it's a little bit more. I cut it here. And I tied up. To make sure what it's exactly 4 inches, that's what I do. I do a little knot here right now. Yes, it's about 4 inches. Make sure it's really strong knot, cut excess of it. Now what you can do, you move this uncomfortable knot close inside your way right there. What it will be not on your way, will be all inside there. And after that, kind of straight up, make sure it's again even, more or less. How to put mask on? You put, you grab like that. This is your mask, this is your ties. You put over your head. After you put over your head, take this one, pulled up a little bit. Because this one go over the head. This one just go over your neck. This one go over your head and go a little bit on behind your head and a little bit more close to the top. And it's in this case, you can wear it. It's good for all day long haul. For somebody who wear it for job for 8+ hours. That will be with little breaks. Well, it's very easy to slide it. If you're going out of car, you just slide it off your face and still on your neck. You don't have to take it on and off and put it somewhere on a surface which is might be instead infested by wire, by virus. That's why it's much more easy to do this way. Much more comfortable. Just like N95 or any good medical PPE will be have this kind of overhead hookup for comfort, not around ears. And after you've done all that, make it Christmas present. Make it very special with love Christmas present. Put initials, like I put this little A for my friend's baby, Angelina, her little A for her, for little little mask, and that's what you can do. That's what you can do to make it literally special. Thank you, guys, and I'm coming like every week. God give me more and more better ideas about how to make this mask asked because I'm breaking my brain how to help to others in this pandemic time. What I can do with my little knowledge, with my little skills to make it possible for us to survive all this pandemic. No, well, keep watching, keep subscribing, because as you can see, I have so much projects on my tables. With this little fishy upholstery fabric, I will show to you how to make very nice something, really another great idea for Christmas present, how easy to make and give to others, just to light up our life anymore a little bit. And please subscribe, what you will not miss that. And much more coming. And before we get to this kind of, because I'm posting another video already this week about Christmas present already ready, how to make case for a cell phone or sunglasses, great idea. But this one will be later, after we make those 90s, which is I promised to you for a while. Well, subscribe, but you will not miss none of it. Thank you guys for your time. Thank you.